Hi, I am Hauki from Fuss Farming. Today I show you the difference between our sheep nettings, what to look out for when making a choice, and how to set up the nets correctly. There are some differences between the nettings, which I will explain now. As you can see, we have nettings in green, which are well suited for an inconspicuous construction in the landscape, or a bright orange to show a clear border between humans and animals. You will find classic and farm net nettings in our store, the main difference being the posts. The classic nettings are equipped with standard posts, same as have been used in the industry for decades. The farm net netting posts, on the other hand, are made from fiberglass and are 6 times stronger than the standard posts and offer considerably more stability. Another difference between the classic and farm net nettings is the connection clip for connecting several nets. The net clip ensures better conductivity and easier connection with other nets and the energizer. The 50 meter nettings have different number of posts. In general, the more posts there are, the more stable the fence will be. In addition, extra posts reduce sagging and avoid unwanted short circuits to the ground. There are also posts with single or double spikes. Double spike posts are easier to get into the ground and have better stability. Our nets are available in different heights, from 90 to 108 centimeters. Depending on the animal size and the ground conditions, there is a suitable height for everyone. You will find different lengths, either in 25 or 50 meters. Depending on your needs, you can connect the nets together to build longer fences. Is the netting too long for your fence? Then you can shorten it. Cut off the axis directly behind the nodes. Threaten a post at the new end of the fence and you will have the right length. The farm net nettings have an additional copper conductor in the top polywire, which ensures an even better current so longer fences can be built. The head insulator on the farm net nettings has a small groove to tension the net more easily. In addition, farm net nettings have even higher quality stainless steel conductors, which are extremely durable. If you're not sure which netting to choose, then definitely choose farm net. When selecting a netting, pay attention to the mesh size. For keeping lambs, a smaller mesh size is recommended. This way, the heads cannot get through. I am now building our farm net with a height of 90 centimeters. For this, we need a netting gate, corner struts, additional posts, and a tensioning set. Start rolling out your netting so that the spikes are where you want your fence to be. Put the posts in the ground one by one. Don't forget to tighten the netting before you insert every post. Next, I build the gate. Make sure there is no space between the netting and the gate, otherwise your animals can escape through the gap. Since the corners are subject to higher tensioning forces, use the struts to reinforce the corners. If the ground is uneven, use the extra posts to stabilize the netting by inserting them between the existing posts at the weakest point. If the soil is soft, we recommend that you use our tensioning set. This prevents the posts from coming loose due to wind or the netting from slacking. Now all you have to do is connect the energizer to your netting and your sheep can go into their newly fenced enclosure. Does your netting have a hole? To guarantee security of your netting, use our universal repair kit. We have them available in green and orange. Use the green wire with the stainless steel conductors and the brass clamps to patch the hole in the netting. If the ground wire is damaged, use the black ground poly wire in which there are no conducting wires. Want to take your fence down? Pull out the posts and lay your netting straight on the ground. Now you can roll it up. Pick up the posts one by one and make sure the bottom strand doesn't get caught in the spikes. That way you'll get it rolled up to the smallest size. And that's how you build a sheep fence. Should you have any questions, you can always contact our customer service team. Here we'll find experts with years of experience. For more tips and tricks about electric fencing, visit our channel.